Hi everyone and welcome to Hobby World. It's almost my wife's birthday and I want to give her something really special this year. The last couple of weeks while I've been working, she has played a lot of Catan on her computer. So I got the bright idea that I could 3D print and paint a complete Catan board game for her. A quick search on Thingiverse revealed a great version of the game with magnetized hexagon tiles and all of the parts required to play. Personally, I'm really impressed at how many great models it's possible to find for free on Thingiverse, so just a quick and heartfelt thanks to all of the great creators which share their designs and models for the rest of us to enjoy. Thank you so much. Well, enough of that. Let's get on with the project. All of the 3D parts have been printed for Catan and it was done in total secrecy. The wife doesn't know anything about this project and as far as I'm concerned, she's not going to find out before she actually gets the gift. This is all of the parts for Catan and as you can see, I have these hexagons here which has 6 small holes in them, each of them. These are for magnets and the idea is that when the magnets are inserted correctly, they will all connect like this and make it very easy to set up the board. So we also have some woods that will fit inside these bases. We have some water and everything that's required for the game. So I've sent the wife away on some tasks today. So I have the house for myself for an hour and a half or so. So I'm pretty hopeful that I'll be able to insert the magnets into all of these parts before she gets back home. And I can hopefully find a way to send her out of the house again and get all of this stuff painted. But right now the task is just get all of those magnets inserted before she gets back home. magnets later and it looks like this. This is incredible and it works really well with the magnets as you can see here. I just position it like this to test out the magnets and how they connect it. So this is of course not the correct setup for the game. But these are all the bases, these hexagon tiles with 6 magnets in each. And they were actually pretty easy inserting except for the yellow and the pink ones. Because they were slightly misprinted and I had to clean them up using a sharp hobby knife and a lot of sandpaper. So, but all in all it ended up looking like this and now I'm going to pry them all and then I'm going to start painting up all of the pieces for the board and those are the ones that's going to look really nice. There are so incredibly many pieces for this game and I've started by taking all of these that's going to be painted up like water and then I'll finish them and then I'll pick up the mountains and the sheep and so on and take them each one step at a time and one type at a time. And I'm going to start with a base coat for these with this old game color, stormy blue, and then I'm going to highlight it with some magic blue. And after that, when it's all dry, I'm probably going to add a bit of white to this and then highlight all of the edges of these waves. And then I will apply a layer of gloss varnish to create the effect of water that's shining. I have painted all of the water tiles and now I only need to finish them by applying a water effect and I'm going to use this water gel which is transparent so this will create a reflection like surface on all of these tiles. So they actually ended up looking pretty good. This didn't take that long, but I'm a bit worried that all of the other pieces with the terrain and landscape are going to take really long to paint. So these were the fast ones, and I still need to paint the harbors. So let's just quickly apply the water gel. As the water is just standing over here and drying now, I am going to start on the forests. And this is a forest tile. We have all of these nice trees, a small house, and a bit of open plain. And I'm going for a mix of a lot of green colors in this, everywhere from dark green to bright green on the small bushes. So I think this is going to look really great. I am going for a cartoonish look, so it's going to be very visible which kind of tile it is. A quick update, I have base coated all of the parts and all of the pieces, and I still need to fix up all of the roads, houses, cities and so on, so there are so much work to do. And the wife's getting home in around half an hour or so, and I need to pack this away, get it away so she doesn't find it. And I'm actually getting a bit worried if I'll be able to finish this project in time, as her birthday is in 4 days or something like that. But she's only away for 1 day more, and I'm beginning to get a bit worried. I think this is going to look absolutely awesome when it's complete, but will I have the time to finish it? That's my concern right now. So I'll just stop this recording and get back to painting and see how much I can get done in half an hour. Let there be water. This is the water tiles for the Catan game, and I used this artificial water effect on top of them, which made them really shiny. And I actually think it looks pretty good. But when I compare them to all of the other tiles I have started on making, then they have a very matte finish. And that means that if I'm using these gloss watery, I think it's becoming a bit too much. So I'm going to dull it all down with a matte varnish on top of all of the water tiles. So I'm just going to apply these, and the time is around 11 o'clock now, and I only have basically this evening as long as I can hang out or keep myself awake to finish this board game, and then I have a couple of hours tomorrow. So it's becoming a pretty tight schedule, but I hope that I can finish it. So I'm going to add a matte varnish to all of these water tiles, paint up these areas in black, I'll show you later why, and then I'm going to finish all of the other tiles. Here we have one of with the sheep, and it actually looks very cute. It's going to look incredible. Got a bit control over all of the water, so it's just placed right here on my work table. It is a complete mess, this work table, at the moment. And now I have found all of the smaller pieces for the game. We have the harbors over here, and then the cities, the houses and the roads. And all of the cities, houses and roads are designed for individual players, so they need their own color set. But I have decided, if we take a look at a city like this, it's a really incredible model printed on in the 3 Pro, and it's very small and it still looks absolutely epic. So I have decided to give all of these a base coat of gray, and do that to all of the cities. And then I'm going to paint all of the roofs in a specific player's colors, so we can distinguish each playing set that way. The roads have this structure, this tile set, and I'm going to paint it, all of the roads, the same. Probably going to apply a wash and then a dry brush to this to create the effect of a cobblestone, and then I'm going to paint the sides in a specific color so it can be identified for a specific player. So a lot of roads I need to paint here, and I need to paint all of the back sides black, so it's going to look good when it's just placed in front of the player and it's mixed up a bit. The harbors are actually very nice models. We have a small ship, they are placed like this, and then we have the harbor itself over here. Small ship and the harbor itself, and I'm going to paint these up with individual cargos over here. So, back to work. Let's just take a look at the evening's work. It's almost 2 a.m. and it's beginning to be a bit late. I'm very tired, but I've managed to do a lot of work with this Catan game, and the wife's birthday is in a couple of days, and she's off to work tomorrow and I have a day off, so I need to finish it tomorrow. But let's just take a look. We have some of the sets here. Nothing of this is actually finished yet, but I have applied all of the washes that is required, and as you can see, it's all over my work table here. There are a lot of tiles and pieces for the game. These roads and city settlements actually took a long time to paint black on the backside and give them a wash, so I hope they will all be dry tomorrow, and then I'll finish up all of these tiles or pieces for the board game, and hopefully I'll manage to do it in time. But I'm actually quite impressed of how this is going to look. I just did a quick setup here to see, and remember, none of these tiles is actually finished, so I think this is going to look really impressive when the entire board is assembled. The city settlements here, house, they will get a bit more color to represent each player, and that will also bring a lot of life into the game itself. So this is the evening's work, and it's beginning to look really impressive, and I am so much looking forward to setting this game up. My poor work table is suffering so much during this, but it's beginning to look really nice. I still need to paint up a lot of the details here, but it is beginning to take form and take shape. If we look over here, all of the small parts, a lot of buildings, and I need to paint all of the roofs here. I decided to paint all of the roofs in red and then paint the small bottom circle down here, the base of the city or settlement, paint that in the player color instead. And same with the roads. I'm simply painting the bottom in the player color, and see now here, it's very visible that this is red players. So I still need to paint the forests over here, and I'm still working on the harbors, but all of the water sections are basically finished, and it's only details I need on all of these pieces. The desert in the center has just been printed and primed, so I still need to do that. But I've just used 3 hours getting here, and oh my god, this is taking so long time. I need to paint the edges of all of these in 3 other colors to represent each players, and it's taking just like forever, and I need to fix up all of the harbors, and yeah, there are still a lot to do, so I'm just going to get to it and see how long time it takes. Well, would you just look at this? This is one of the messiest work tables I've had for a long, long time. I simply ended up using all of the table to get the room for all of these pieces. There are hundreds of pieces, that was so many, especially all of the game pieces, player pieces up here, there were so many. And I know it's only small roads and so on, but the fact that I needed to paint them all individually, that took so long time. Just picking them up, painting, and then setting them down again. So troublesome work. And I think that I'm going to finish this project in time. The wife gets home in about half an hour, and I can possibly find a bit of time tomorrow to finish the rest. But I have all of the main pieces here, and a bit somewhat here, over here where I've attached them, and then I have a lot of the water and harbors here. I still need to do all of the details and highlight the pieces. That's not completely necessary, as it actually looks very good as it is right now, but it needs to be highlighted for me to be completely satisfied with it, or else it's just too plain, and that would be a shame when I've used so much time already on the project. So it ended up looking like this. I used a wash on all of the parts. In the beginning I didn't want to use a wash, but I actually think that it connected all of the pieces really well, and especially on the mountains gave that a bit extra. On the clay pieces here, it did a really good job. So I will have to add a couple of highlights to this to make it look a bit cartoonish again. But all in all, I'm very satisfied and I'm looking forward to setting the game board up and taking a look at how it looks when it's finished. Time to finish this project. As you can see, all of the initial work is done and complete, and now I only need to pick up each of these individual tiles and finish up all of the details, because in the end, that's what's going to make this board game look really great. Finally, finally done. Just take a look at all of these small pieces. They actually look very nice. This is the small settlements and cities, and I'm really, really happy about how they turned out. I could have used a bit more time on them to fix up all small details and so on, but considering that I have painted literally a lot of models here, I think this is very nice. I am very happy about it, and I'm going to assemble all of the game now and see how it looks. But this is so satisfying watching this finished. I have all the roads up here, they have been color marked for each player, and these simply look amazing. Welcome to our board gaming room. I am very proud to present the final 3D printed version of Catan.
Ja, jeg tror så. Det er lidt flere kort.